Dogs are known as man's best friend, so it's no wonder that the English language has so many idioms related to animals. Let's stop monkeying around and get started talking about 20 animal-related idioms. Badger someone. To badger someone means to persuade someone to do exactly what you want by repeatedly bothering them or often asking them questions. The police badger the suspect with question after question until eventually he gave them the information that they wanted. An eager beaver. An eager beaver is a person who's very busy working hard, but with a lot of enthusiasm. They're usually very interested in starting or doing the project at hand. Wow, you're such an eager beaver. I can't believe you're all packed for your trip. It's not for another 10 days. A busy bee. A busy bee is someone who's a very busy and active person who's quickly going from project to project. She's a real busy bee today. She's been rushing around all morning. Make a beeline for something. To make a beeline for something means to hurry towards something, taking the quickest and most direct way there. When I arrived at home, I made a beeline to my couch to make sure I caught the latest episode of The Bachelor. An early bird. An early bird is someone who gets up early and usually gets their work done earlier than others. I'm definitely an early bird. I do my best work early in the morning, so usually I get up at 5 a.m. every day. The opposite of this is a night owl, and that's a person who prefers to stay up late and is more productive in the nighttime. Entertainers and bartenders are usually night owls. So are you an early bird or a night owl? A lone wolf. A lone wolf is a person who prefers his or her own company and has little to no social contact with others. As I've gotten older, I've become more of a lone wolf. I'd rather spend my time doing things that I enjoy than having to worry about entertaining others. Bug someone. To bug someone means to bother, annoy, or irritate someone else. Would you stop bugging me? I'm trying to work. Take the bull by the horns. To take the bull by the horns means to face a challenge or problem face on, instead of avoiding it. She decided to take the bull by the horns and tell her boss that she didn't agree with his idea for the new website. To have butterfly in one's stomach. If you have butterflies in your stomach, that means you're nervous and generally about something good that's about to happen. The bride had butterflies in her stomach before walking down the aisle. Be no spring chicken. If someone is no spring chicken, they're no longer young. In my head, I feel young, but my body is telling me I'm no spring chicken. I found my first white hair the other day. Chicken out of doing something. To chicken out of doing something means to stop participating in an activity because you're afraid or because it has become too difficult or dangerous. I was supposed to go skydiving, but I chickened out. I ended up staying home and watching YouTube instead. Crocodile tears. Crocodile tears means insincere or fake tears. Some people found that Kyle Rittenhouse had crocodile tears when they watched his testimony on the stand. He was emotional, but didn't actually shed a single tear. Dog-eared. Dog-eared is an adjective that refers to when people take a corner of a book that they're reading and fold it down. It's a cheap way to bookmark someone's place in a book. This book must be good. It's dog-eared, so it must have been borrowed several times. Go to the dogs. If something goes to the dogs, it's slowly declining into a very bad condition or state. Now, usually we're referring to the economics of a company or a country, but you can also refer to the condition of a building or a home. The hoarder had such a bad problem that she allowed her house to go to the dogs even while she still lived there. A fish out of water. As you can imagine, a fish out of water would not be comfortable, and this means the exact same thing. When you're a fish out of water, you're not in your normal habitat, so you feel uncomfortable. When I first visited Japan, I felt like a fish out of water. The food, the language, and the customs were so different. But then I really enjoyed the differences. And now I think about Japan as one of my favorite countries to visit in the world. Have other or have bigger fish to fry. We use have other or we have bigger fish to fry when we have more important things to do or worry about. I have bigger fish to fry than to sit around gossiping. I need to get started on my project. A wild goose chase. A wild goose chase refers to a search or an investigation that has no chance of success. For my proposal, my husband sent me on a wild goose chase. I had to go throughout New York City looking for clues. Lucky for me, I had a friend with me who helped me when I got some of the clues wrong, straight from the horse's mouth. With all the fake news going around, people prefer to get their news and information straight from the horse's mouth. This means that they are hearing the information from the person who knows most or has the most authority about a given subject. Now, why do we use the horse to mean getting accurate information? It actually has to do with horse racing. Around the turn of the 20th century, the jockeys and trainers were the people closest to racehorses, both figuratively and physically. And therefore, they were the best sources of pre-race tips. This idiomatic expression developed to suggest that hearing such a tip straight from the horse's mouth would be a tip even better than the best. There's also a theory claiming that the phrase may have to do with the fact that examining horses' teeth could provide information on its physical condition. Either way, it means getting accurate information. Hold one's horses. To hold one's horses means to be patient, to wait, or to slow down. Now, we usually use this phrase in the imperative as a command or a warning to someone to wait. I know you want to buy that shirt right now, but hold your horses. That store is planning a huge sale on Black Friday, and I know you'll get a better deal if you can just wait. Rat on someone. To rat on someone means to betray someone to the police or to the person in authority. Those two aren't friends anymore because Sandra ratted John out to the boss for leaving work early. The English challenge of the day is to describe yourself or an experience you had using one of the idioms you learned today. Now hold your horses. Before you make a beeline to that next video, make sure to like, subscribe, and check out this video on the best strategies for learning phrasal verbs.